Belfry, I'm outside Star Labs. The whole building is in lockdown. They might be doing maintenance.
That would explain how they got in. Better check if you can find an opening.
Belfry?
Yeah!
What was that? Them. Let's do this. A mile away. Over yet. Guys to deal with. Try not committing crimes. We're unstoppable.
Now that's just embarrassing.
Broke a sweat. That was some solid teamwork.
About time you showed up.
Batgirl, at your service. And what should I call you?
If I don't need to know your real name, you don't need to know mine. I got grandkids to think about. You can just call me Madame Palomares.
All right, Madame Palomares. I got your message. You said you had some information for me?
I do. What I'm about to tell you is highly confidential. There's a group of us. People who want to see real change in Gotham. We call ourselves the Watch.
Sounds serious.
I started the group years ago when I got fed up with all the bad apples in this town.
Like someone else I know.
I reached out to Batman for help. He wasn't too sure about us at first, but I showed him that having eyes on the ground could be useful. So we started giving him tips to help him keep our neighborhood safe. He told me that if he ever went quiet for this long, that I should reach out to you.
I'm glad you did. I promise. I'll do everything I can to keep your neighborhood safe.
I'll spread the word to the other members of the Watch. He is missed. But the entire Watch has your back. We can do this. Together. That's it for tonight, dear.
Training. They always talk tough. They didn't stand a chance against us. That's interesting.
Mm-hmm. look like your usual tree.
Countdown time!
This isn't right.
No way, Batgirl! I'm out of here! This...
Did you hear anything about freaks teaming up with citizens for crime stuff?
That better be a joke.
Maybe, maybe not.
I'm not seeing anything. Try and find out what you can.
We're almost there.
Better get out of here.
Thank you.
this shaft. Don't live your life, recue it. Maybe this will help.
Thank you.
is heavily secured. If you're spotted, you won't get a chance to upload the data.
Pass.
She made a break for it. We can't let anyone disrespect the force.
I got a mask here.
Don't give her the chance to escape.
She's running. I've got her.
Clayface, why are you doing this?
Shit! This is serious!
We're gonna need more than that for the analysis. I'm dying to try this baby out. How do I start?
You're getting ahead of yourself. Before you can use the bird, you'll have to clear a path for it.
Whatever I need to do.
Lately, the GCPD is not content to have jackboots on the ground. They've launched a network of surveillance drones to patrol the skies. If they're looking for you when you try to get airborne...
They won't hesitate to take me down. What do you recommend?
A creative programmer could convince those drones to overlook certain targets. But for that to work, close-up scans would be required.
For once, I'm not the one who has to handle the programming. I'll get you those scans, Mr. Fox.
The cops have the city divided into sectors, with a set of drones watching over each one. Until you scan all the drones in a sector, consider it a no-fly zone.
No flying until the surveillance drones are taken care of? No problem.
I'll send you the location of the first one so you can get to work.
To do it. Belfry, I've got a bunch of clay for us to analyze.
Thanks. Get back here and we'll take a look.
Thank you.
location.
Not playing around this time.
I put some new info on the board. Damn it.
Judging from the list of stolen items, I'd say he's looking to upgrade his exosuit. And that's just for starters.
He also downloaded local weather balloon data for the past 10 years.
Let's go back out there and stop Breeze before he kills anyone else. Yes!
Easy, Tiger. We'll get him. Maybe that's enough practice for today.
I've set the back computer to monitor the city for high concentrations of cryogel.
Meanwhile, we should keep tabs on anyone working for Freeze, which should be easy since he decks out all of his lackeys with cryo guns.
Don't understand. Clayface fell in a turbine when he last fought Batman. How is he still alive?
I'm not sure. He was torn to shreds.
And yet, here we are.
Guess getting blended like a smoothie wasn't enough for him.
So, what did we learn about our new friend?
Well, I've studied Clayface's DNA before, and this is unlike anything I've ever seen. The structure's constantly changing. It's like it can't reassemble itself.
We're talking damaged nucleotides, unstable phosphate groupings, and synthesis abnormalities. I mean, abnormal even for Clayface.
This sample seems especially disorganized, like it's trying to be five things at once.
Oh, maybe it's because these pieces of him on their own aren't enough for him to stabilize into a singular conscious entity.
You guys are doing your nerd thing again.
Sorry. Clayface might be in too many places at once, and he's having trouble being anything because of it.
But the more that Clayface comes together, the stronger and smarter he gets.
We definitely do not want that.
Well, what if he's already conscious? I mean, we can't just leave him like this.
Putting him back together could endanger the whole city. We can't take that chance.
Either way, it doesn't do us any good if we don't know where he is. The reservoir is connected to the city's aqueduct system. He could be anywhere.
There are probably still bits of him in the water, too.
It's nice knowing you, Jason.
He'll be fine. Probably.
I'll scan the city for the Clay's unique signature. I'll let you all know if I find something.
Yeah, have fun with that.
Reports of creature attacks continue to pour in. Eyewitnesses say the assailants resemble giant, man-like bats. More as the story develops.
There's new stuff on the board.
So the pills were prescribed by some doctor no one's even heard of. Any other leads?
The website for the mysterious Dr. Q seems to have vanished, but we'll keep looking.
I haven't been able to find direct evidence of Harley being attached to this, but I know it's her. So what's her angle?
Is that not always the question with Dr. Quinzel?
Let me know when you find something, Alfred.
Of course.